Right. Let's take the transfer function given open loop transfer function g of s equal to k into s plus 1.5 by s into s plus 1 into s plus 5. Adhe kada, isn't it? This is the given open loop transfer function. So tell me one by one, what is the first step? What is the first step? Step one in the root locus.
Root controls.
Tell me, repeat it, Nana.
Location of poles and roots.
Right. Location of poles and zeros. Okay. Location of poles and zeros. 1 minute. Hello. Madam, class lo unnam tarvata. So location of poles and zeros. So first we need to find what are the poles are in the given transfer function. Tell me what are the poles?
0, minus 1, minus 5.
0, minus 1, minus 5. What are the zeros we have? What are the zeros we have? What are the zeros we have? Minus 1.5 and
infinite.
Very good. Next thing calculate cheyali step number 1 lo.
Number of RL branches.
What is the condition?
P greater than 0.
P greater than Z or P less than Z. We have to check the condition. P greater than Z or P less than Z. So P greater than Z or P less than Z. P greater than Z is the number of branches, RL branches equal to P. P less than Z is the number of RL branches equal to number of zeros. So which condition is satisfied? P greater than Z or P less than Z? Which condition is satisfied for the given transfer function?
P greater than Z
is satisfied. Very good. So how many RL branches we have?
3, sir.
3. That is number of poles. 3. Okay. Next. Number of RL branches terminates at infinite. How do we calculate?
P minus Z, sir.
Very good, Nana. P minus Z. So 3 minus Z means how many?
1, sir.
1. Very good. P minus Z is 2. Okay. So this is the first step. What is the second step?
RL branch and real axis.
Right. RL branches on real axis. We have to take the test point and we have to observe the number of total number of poles and zeros to the right hand side of the test point. If it is odd, then the test point is lies on the real axis RL branch. If it is even, then the test point is not lies on the real axis RL branch. Okay. What is number 3? Step number 3. What is step number 3?
Asymptotes.
Right. First calculate number of asymptotes. What is the formula? For number of asymptotes? Capital N equal to?
P minus Z.
So 3 minus 1. How many asymptotes we have?
2, sir.
2. Coming to angle of asymptotes. Angle of asymptote. 180. 2q plus 1 by p minus z, where q equal to 0, 1, 2 and so on up to p minus z minus 1. So where p minus z is 2. So that is q is 0 comma 1, only two values. That is we have only two asymptotes and we are getting only two angles. So 180 into q equal to 0 means 1 by 2. What is the angle? First angle?
90, sir.
90. Coming to second one. 180, 3 by 2. What is the angle? What is the angle? 270 or 270 or Dinala Rasko, 217. Minus 90. Okay. Minus 90. Okay. So plus 90 and one more angle is minus 90. So next, now step number 3 not yet completed. We have to calculate. We have to calculate. Tell me, we have to calculate.
Centroid, sir.
Centroid. P minus J. So sigma PR, sum of real part of the poles. What are the poles we have? What are the poles we have?
0, minus 1, minus 5.
0, minus 1, minus 5. Sum of the poles. Minus. What are the zeros we have?
Minus 1.5.
Minus. Chepandi, minus 1.5. P minus J. So minus 6 plus 1.5 by 2. Minus 6 plus 1.5 by 2. How much it is? How much it is? How much it is?
Minus 2.25.
Minus 2.25. Very good. This is the centroid. What is the step number 4? What is step number 4?
Breakpoint, sir.
Breakpoint. So, breakpoint. So, we have, what is the procedure for calculate breakpoint? What is the procedure to calculate breakpoint? Tell me fast.
Characteristic equation.
So we have to write the characteristic equation first. So 1 plus, what is the given transfer function? K into S plus 1.5 by S into S plus 1 into S plus 5, right? What is H of S? What is H of S? What is H of S? How much it is?
1, sir.
1. So, take the LCM. S into S square plus 6S plus 5. Right? Plus K into S plus 1.5 equal to 0. S cube 6S square 5S plus K into S plus 1.5 equal to 0. So what is the next step? Write the K as function of S. Write the K as function of S. From this, what is K? Minus of S cube plus 6S square plus 5S divided by S plus 1.5. S plus 1.5. Okay, S plus 1.5. What is the formula? What is the next step? We have to derivate dK by dS and equate to 0. So the dK by dS, nothing but d by dS of minus S cube plus 6S square plus 5S by S plus 1.5. Right? So equate to 0. dk by ds equal to 0 nothing but d by ds of s cube plus 5s square, right? S cube plus 5s square, sorry, 5 or 6? 6s.
6s
square plus 5s by s plus 1.5. What is the formula for d by u by v formula? Anyone?
U dash minus u v dash by v square.
Dina? Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Right. Do it. And equate to 0, right? So, minus sign in omit chestama. Okay, is it clear? Here we have minus sign actually. So, when it is equate to 0, I have to omit the negative sign. Okay? Is it clear? Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes,
negative sign on the other monkey previously, this negative sign, when I equate the 0, I remove that negative sign. Is it clear? Is it clear? Say yes or no. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. VDU. VDU. So 3s square plus 12s plus 5 into s plus 1.5 minus UDV. S cube plus 6s square plus 5s. So this is derivative of U and derivative of V. What is the derivative of V? 1. Right? Simplify it. So what we are getting, which is equal to 0. If you simplify it, 3s cube plus 4.5s square plus 12s square plus 18, right? 18s plus 5s plus 7.5 minus s cube 6s square plus 5s by s plus 1.5 whole square. So finally, we have after simplification 2s cube, 4.5s square, 12s square, 16.s square, 16.5s square, minus 6, so 10s square, minus 10.5s square, minus 10.5s square. Next, 18s, 5s, 23s, 18s. Next, plus 7.5. Right. So finally, we have, what is the numerator here? Denominator, if you take this to it, right hand side, it gets multiplied by 0. So directly I am writing 2s cube plus 10.5s square plus 18s plus 7.5. 18s plus 7.5 equal to 0. So s cube 5.25s square divided by 2. 9s plus 3.75 equal to 0. So what is the, what are the roots we have? What are the roots we have? And roots ఏం వస్తాయి? Calculate in the calculator. You need to calculate the roots in the using the calculator. చెప్పండి అమ్మా ఎంత వచ్చాయి రూట్స్? క్యాలిక్యులేటర్స్ ఉన్నాయా? ఇస్ ఎనీబడి హ్యావ్ క్యాలిక్యులేటర్? ఇస్ ఎనీబడి హ్యాస్ క్యాలిక్యులేటర్ ఆర్ నాట్? అమ్మా క్యాలిక్యులేటర్స్ ఉన్నాయా దగ్గర?
మైనస్
606 అంతేనా?
606
ఓకే. వన్ అదర్ రూట్స్ రిమైనింగ్ టూ. వి హావ్ త్రీ రూట్స్ రైట్? వి ఆర్ గెటింగ్ త్రీ రూట్స్.
3 టు 1
టెల్ మీ 3 టు 1
మైనస్ 2.3 టు 1 ప్లస్ ఆర్ మైనస్ 8.9 జే
మైనస్ మైనస్ repeat it minus 2.3
plus or minus 0.89 j
0.89 so we are getting two complex conjugate roots and one real root. So in these three roots, which is valid, which are invalid? In these three roots, which are valid and which are invalid? What is breakaway point? What is break point or breakaway point?
Minus 0.606.
Okay. What is break point? I am asking the definition. What is the definition of breakaway point? What is the definition of breakaway point? Tell me the definition. What is the definition point of breakaway point?
From which poles leaving the real axis.
Yeah, the point at which poles are leaving the real axis. So ee mooditla evi real axis meed untadi? E value untunda, idu untunda?
-0.6.
So it is valid break point. It is, these two are invalid break points. Is it clear, all of you? Right. What is step number 5?
Angle of departure.
Angle of departure or arrival. Angle of departure or arrival. Okay. Is it applicable for this problem? Step number 5?
No, sir.
So you have to write all the poles and zeros of given transfer function are real values, are real. So there is no need to calculate angle of departure or arrival. You have to write this statement at number 5. Step number 5. Right. What is step number 6? What is step number 6?
Intersection point.
Intersection point
on the image, on the imaginary axis.
On intersection point on imaginary axis. on imaginary axis. So how do we find? Write the characteristic equation. RH, apply RH criteria. Find K margin. Find the roots of auxiliary equation. Right. What is the characteristic equation we have? What is the characteristic equation? Manaku vachindanta chesam. This is the characteristic equation, isn't it? S cube plus 6s square plus 5s. S cube plus 6s square plus 5s plus k into s plus 0.5, right? K into s plus 0.5 equal to 0. S plus 1.5 equal to 0. So s cube plus 6s square plus s into k plus 1 plus 1.5k equal to 0. I am taking the s common from these two terms. 5s kada, sorry, k plus 5. Okay, it is k plus 5, right? So what is the maximum power? S cube, s square, s power 1, s power 0, 1, k plus 5, 6, 1.5k. So what is this term? Anyone please tell me? What is the s power 1 term? What is the s power 1 term? చెప్పండి నాన్న, ఏ బి, వాట్ ఇస్ సి నాట్? చెప్పండి, వాట్ ఇస్ సి నాట్? వాట్ ఇస్ సి నాట్? Fast, we have to do one more problem using complex conjugate zeros. Fast, what is C naught?
Minus 5.
Is it correct, all of you? Is it correct? Yes or no?
Minus 0.75k, sir.
Minus 0.75k
minus 5.
Oh, God, only minus 10. Is it correct? All of you. Say yes or no. Is it correct or not? చేసారా బాయ్స్? ఇది మైనసేనా ప్లస్ లా? బయట మైనస్ ఉంది, చూసారా? మా ఇది కరెక్టేనా, మైనసేనా? ఈ రెండు మైనస్లేనా? బయట ఇది మైనస్ అప్లై చేశారా? హలో,
ప్లస్ వస్తుంది సార్ రెండింటికి.
एम्मा इवे मिस्टेक्स चेसेदी सो यू आर गेटिंग 0.75 के प्लस 5 राइट सो व्हाट इज के मार्जिन हाउ डू यू कैलकुलेट के मार्जिन K margin, marginal stability approximately. What is the case? What is the case when you are getting marginal stable system? When we get marginal stable system,
row of all zeros.
Row of all zeros. So you have to equate this to zero. So 0.75 k plus 5 equal to zero. K equal to minus 5 by 0.75. What is the value? What is the value? K margin.
Minus 6.66.
Minus 6.6. Minus 6.6. Okay, K margin is minus 6.6. What is auxiliary equation? What is auxiliary equation? If it is 0, what is the auxiliary equation? If it is equal to 0, what is auxiliary equation?
6 square plus 1.5 K equals.
Right. Auxiliary equation is 6s square plus 1.5k equal to 0. So 6s square plus 1.5 into minus 6.6 equal to 0. So 6s square equal to, what is the value? 1.5 into 6.6. 1.5 into 6.6, what is the value?
9.9, sir.
9.9. What is s square? How much it is? How much 1.65. So s cube equal to plus or minus square root of 1.65. How much it is? Square root of 1.65. How much? square root of 1.6? Bhargav, are you there? Bhargav.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
In matladre enti?
1.284, sir.
నేను అడిగిందని చెప్పు, ఏంటి మాట్లాడట్లేదు అంటే నేను అడిగేది ఎవరిని? పిచ్చి పిచ్చిగా ఉన్నాయండి. బాలాజీ ఉన్నావా? బాలాజీ ఏం చేస్తున్నారు క్లాసుల్లో? మినిమం క్యాలిక్యులేటర్ గ్రాఫ్స్ దగ్గర పెట్టుకోమని చెప్పాను కదా. మొబైల్ ఉంటుంది కదా, క్యాలిక్యులేటర్ లేకపోతే ఇంట్లో మొబైల్స్ ఉండవా? వాట్ ఈస్ ద వాల్యూ ఆఫ్ స్క్వేర్ రూట్ ఆఫ్ 1.65?
1.284.
వాట్ స్క్వేర్ రూట్ ఆఫ్ 1.65 ఈస్ 1.22? మ్యాథమెటిక్స్ వచ్చా? వాట్ ఈస్ స్క్వేర్ రూట్ ఆఫ్
1.65?
హౌ మచ్?
1.284.
Wait a minute.
So,
are we getting any imaginary term? Imaginary. imaginary nothing but we are getting like this j of something. Are we getting? Say yes or no.
No, sir.
So I think there is no valid intersection point on imaginary axis. So you are not getting valid intersection points on imaginary axis. So enduku raledu anedi manaku ippudu graph draw chestho telustundi. We are not getting imaginary points on the we are not getting intersection points on the imaginary axis. So we'll draw the graph. All of you take the graph and draw the graph sheet. Today I will ask some person to send the graph sheet to me immediately. Within 10 minutes, send the graph sheet to me. Otherwise, I mark the absent for entire this week. I mark the absent for that person who are unable to submit the graph sheet within 10 minutes to me after drawing with me. Okay, tell me, what are the poles we have? What are the poles we have in the given problem?
Zero, minus one, minus five.
Okay, wait a minute. Rule number 408, are you there? Rule number 408. 408. See, your friends are leaving the class. Rule number 413. Rule number 413. Now, that means if you not respond, I will mark the absent for entire 1 week. Mind it. 413. I shall ask another. 424. Rule number 424.
Sir.
Yeah. After completion of the problem, send the graph sheet.
Okay, sir.
Okay, na? Post it in the group.
Okay, sir.
$429.
Sir.
You also. Okay?
Okay.
Right. $453. $453. You also, Amma. Okay, na?
Okay, sir.
Right. 477.
Yes, sir.
You also. Okay?
Okay.
Within 10 minutes. After completion of the class, take the photo and paste it with your number. Write your roll number on the graph sheet. First of all, write your roll number on the graph sheet. Take the snapshot and placed it in the group. Okay. 483 Gunashekar, are you there? 483. 483 Gunashekar. 483. 495 Sindhu.
Yes, sir.
So send the graph sheet. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Next, 408. 20 series 408. If you not respond, I have placed absent. I marked you as a absent for this week. 404. Right. 489. Absent. 488. Okay, nice. Absent.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, send the graph sheet. Okay.
Yes.
Right. Yes, so 413, 483, 20 series 408, 404, 489, and 488. These are absent for this week, entire week. Okay. Right. We'll come to graph sheet. Right. So what are the poles we have? Tell me.
0, minus 1, minus 5.
0, minus 1, minus 5. Okay. Okay, what are the zeros we have?
Minus 1.5.
Minus 1.5. So see here. Minus 1.5. You have to mark the zero with small circle. With small circle like this. Okay. Right. Marked the poles and zeros. What is the second step? What is the second step?
RL branch and rail axis.
Right. Take the test point at pole zero. Pole zero. So are there any poles and zeros to right hand side of this pole?
No, sir.
No. So there is no. So real axis RL branch to right hand side of this test point. Okay. That is this side. Okay. Take one more test point at S equal to minus one pole. So how many number of poles and zeros to its right
one
side?
One pole, zero, zero.
One right. Pole, sir.
So what is it? Is odd or even?
Odd, sir.
So we have to draw the RL branch between zero pole and minus one pole with dark line. With dark line. Zero and minus one. Coming to next test point, that is 1.5. We have zero, right? Minus 1.5. At minus 1.5, we have zero. Sai. So take this test point. How many zeros and poles to its right side?
Two poles, sir.
So which is even or odd?
Even, sir.
So there is no RL branch between minus one pole and 1.50. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Right. Take one more test point at S equal to minus five pole. How many poles and zeros to its right hand side?
102 poles, sir.
102 poles. What is the sum?
Odd, sir.
Total 3, right? Which is odd. So that means we have real axis RL branch between -5 pole and 1.50. Okay. Right. Now step number 3. How many asymptotes we have? How many asymptotes we have?
2, sir.
2. What are the angle of asymptotes?
What 90 are the minus 90.
Minus 90. What is centroid?
Minus 2.25.
So minus 1, minus 2. So I think it is the centroid. -2.25. You have to note down, Aman, take the note. Break point must lies on the real axis RL branch. But centroid, coming to centroid, no need to lie on real axis RL branch. So very important, the difference. Break point and compulsory real axis RL branch with the locate ayundal. But centroid avasaram ledu ekkadaina locate avundochu endukante ikku meer chuste -2.25 idi real axis rl branch meedu unda manaki unnattu undi right undi kada -2.25 anedi real axis rl branch meeda unda real axis rl branch ekkada nunchi undi manaki -1.50 nunchi -5 pole varaku unda avuna ante na
yes sir
So -2.5 అంటే ఇన్ బిట్వీన్ ఏ కదా రైట్ సో రియల్ యాక్సిస్ ఆర్ఎల్ బ్రాంచ్ మీద ఉన్నా పర్లేదు లేకపోయినా పర్లేదు నో నీడ్ సెంట్రాయిడ్ కి కానీ బ్రేక్ పాయింట్ మాత్రం కంపల్సరీ రియల్ యాక్సిస్ ఆర్ఎల్ బ్రాంచ్ మీద ఉండాలి దట్ ఈస్ ద వ్యాలిడ్ బ్రేక్ పాయింట్ అంతేనా మనం చెప్పుకుంది ఏదైతే రియల్ యాక్సిస్ ఆర్ఎల్ బ్రాంచ్ మీద ఉందో దట్ ఈస్ ద వ్యాలిడ్ బ్రేక్ పాయింట్ అంతేనా అదే కదా మనం చెప్పుకుంది Isn't it or not? Isn't it or
yes,
not?
Sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
So -2.25. So what are the angle of asymptotes? What are the angles
minus
of 90 minus 90. So 90 minus 90 means you have to draw the perpendicular lines. This is plus 90. Right, like this, minus 90 angle, right. Step number 3 complete. What about break point? Step number 4, how much? How much? Break point.
Minus 0.606.
Suppose take this one. -0.606. It is the break away point. Break away na avutundi. Endukante poles kada ikkada unnai manaki. Ee poles leave avvali. Right. Okay. Step number 5. Angle of departure and arrival unda manaki.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Step number 6.
Imaginary
axis. Unnaya valid? Are we have valid intersection points or not? Valid imaginary axis intersection points vachaya manaki chesthe?
No, sir.
No. Right. Now it's time to draw the RL branch. So first, ikkada 1.5 daggara undi kada? 1.5 daggara 0 undi kada? అవునా ఉందా
yes sir
so always poles trying to meet the zeros isn't it pole is trying to meet the
yes sir
zero, zero. So here -5 pole meet the zeros meet the zero at 1.5 okay -5 on a pole మైనస్ 1.5 అనే జీరోని మీట్ అయింది. మరి ఇవి కూడా ఉన్నాయిగా మైనస్ వన్ మైనస్ జీరో, ఇవి ఎందుకు వెళ్ళట్లేదు ఇటువైపు? మైనస్ వన్ అనే పోల్ ఉంది, జీరో అనే పోల్ ఉంది, ఇది ఎందుకు వెళ్ళట్లేదు ఇటు? ఇవి ఎందుకు వెళ్ళట్లేదు చెప్తారా? రైట్, వెరీ గుడ్ నానా. దెర్ ఇస్ నో రియల్ యాక్సిస్ ఆర్ఎల్ బ్రాంచ్ పాత్ హియర్. ఇక్కడ మైనస్ వన్ కి మైనస్ 1.5 కి మనకి ఆర్ఎల్ బ్రాంచ్ పాత్ ఉందా? రియల్ యాక్సిస్ ఆర్ఎల్ బ్రాంచ్, సో అక్కడికి పాత్ లేదు. రైట్, అక్కడికి పాత్ లేదు. సో నీకు ఇక్కడ ఉన్న నీకు పాత్ దేనికి ఉంది? మైనస్ 5 అనే పోల్ కి. ఈ 1.5 జీరోకి రీచ్ అవడానికి నీకు పాత్ ఉంది, అందుకే మైనస్ 5 అనే పోల్, మైనస్ 1.5. మరి ఇవి ఎక్కడ, ఇవి ఎక్కడ మీట్ అవుతాయి జీరోస్ ని? మైనస్ 1 అండ్ జీరో పోల్ జీరోస్ ఎక్కడ మీట్ అవుతాయి?
ఇన్ఫైనైట్.
సో వీ హ్యావ్ అసిమ్టోట్స్ రైట్ హియర్, జీరో ఎట్ ఇన్ఫైనైట్, వన్ మోర్ జీరో ఎట్ ఇన్ఫైనైట్. సో వాట్ ఈస్ బ్రేక్ పాయింట్? వాట్ ఈస్ ద వాల్యూ?
0.606.
మైనస్ 4 పోల్ స్టార్టెడ్ లైక్ దిస్. మైనస్ 4 అనే పోల్, మైనస్ 1 అనే పోల్ స్టార్టెడ్ లైక్ దిస్, ఇలా. దిస్ ఇస్ బ్రేక్ పాయింట్. 0 అనే పోల్ స్టార్టెడ్ లైక్ దిస్, దిస్ ఇస్ రైట్, దిస్ ఇస్ 0 పోల్, 0 పోల్ and it is minus 1 pole. This is break point, which is minus 0.606. So when these two poles are meet at this point, they are leaving like this. One is leaving like this, one is leaving like this. So one is moving like this, parallel to asymptote. One more is moving like this, parallel to asymptote. So this is the direction. One pole moving like this, parallel to asymptotes. Another pole moving like this, parallel to asymptote. So how many RL branches we have? 1, 2, 3. How many RL branches are heading towards infinite? Step number 1 lo calculate chesam. How many?
2, sir.
2. So this is 1 and this is 2. So this is our root locus. So no intersection point on imaginary axis. Without intersection point on imaginary axis, we have completed the root locus. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I will give one exam, one exercise for you. Solve while coming to tomorrow's class. Okay? While coming for tomorrow's class, all of you try to solve this. We'll give you the problem. All of you note down. Try to solve this problem. If you have any doubts, go through textbook. Complete it. Okay, tomorrow I will ask selected people. Okay? So draw the root locus for the given transfer function. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Right. Tomorrow we have two special problems. So with those two problems, I will conclude the root locus. Okay. Okay. I am again repeating the numbers. 424, 429, 453, 477, 495, 482. Send the graph sheets, pics. Similarly, 413, 483, 488, 489, 20 series 405 and 408. You are absent for entire this week. Okay, control system classes. I marked the absent for these people. So that's the end of today's class. Thank you.